Hey friends, Sleepy here. Welcome to the episode of the Weekly Playlist. It's Friday, so you guys know what that means. It's time for me to share the games I've been playing during the week with you. I have been having an absolute blast with this series. I really enjoy all the interaction I've been having with you guys, and just been having a lot of fun playing all these games in my collection because, you know, as much as it is fun to collect these games, you know, it's even more fun to actually take the time to play and enjoy them, which I hope a lot of you who do the collecting, you know, that your main goal is to play the games that you do pick up, because it's a lot more fun to actually play games and actually have fun with them. And that's why I've enjoyed having this series, so I can share with you guys the games I have been playing, to give you guys ideas on games to play, and then also to get ideas of games for me to check out from you guys, because I do enjoy hearing about the games you guys are playing and any recommendations you guys have on games that you think I should check out. Let me know, because you guys always recommend really fun games, and I do have a nice list going on my website, so I've been having a lot of fun with this series, so I'll let you guys know my thoughts on these two games I've been playing this week. I'd like to hear your guys' thoughts on them, if you played them before or not. I'd also like to hear what games you guys are currently playing right now, and if you have a recommendation of title you think I should check out, let me know, because you guys do always recommend really fun titles. So we'll get started here. I've been playing on my PlayStation 2 and my Xbox One. So first game for PlayStation 2 I've been playing is X-Men Origins Wolverine, which this game is really fun. I just recently picked this game up, actually, last month. Got a great deal for it on my local game store. Really fun game. I only paid $5 for it. And it's a lot different than the X-Men Origins Wolverine that was on Xbox 360 and PS3. That was called the Uncaged Edition. And the gameplays are similar, but the actual game itself is different, where this one follows more closely to the X-Men Origins Wolverine movie, where the game followed it but also deviated and had a little bit difference. One of the big differences, of course, is obviously the graphics on the 360 and PS3 version are a lot better. They're a lot more violent and bloody. Like, if Wolverine, when he takes damage in the Uncaged Edition, you can actually see his animantium skeleton underneath, and it's all bloody, and as his health chips away, you know, you can see chunks of him missing, and you can see his animantium skeleton underneath. It's really cool, and then it has really bloody graphics and real vicious attacks on guys, where this PS2 one's kind of a toned-down version, you know. It's still violent, but not as violent as that, because, you know, the hardware is more limited with the PlayStation 2 over like an Xbox 360 was. But it's still a fun game. Really having fun with this and enjoying it and playing through the story. I'm in the first quarter of the game is complete, and I've already had some cool boss battles that are really fun. You know, there's also some quick time events, which I don't remember if they were in the Uncaged Edition or not. You know, we have to hit a certain button prompt at a certain time in different battles. And it's really cool, those different locales you get to go through. So you start off in the Canadian forest, where Logan is trying to just live a peaceful life, and then his brother Victor gets involved. And if you've seen the movie, you'll know the basic premise of the story. But that's basically what this game follows through, and I'm having a lot of fun with it. And right now, you know, he doesn't have his animantium skeleton. You know, he ends up acquiring that in this game. And the movie talk about how he gets his skeleton on him, and you actually will get that as you play through the story. So I haven't reached that part of the story yet, but still a really good game. Now, if you played the Uncaged Edition and you enjoyed it, you will enjoy this one. I do have to warn you, though, that sometimes the controls felt a little slippery. Like, I swear, sometimes when I was jumping in some of the areas, like, it just didn't respond to my jump prompt, and he just fell down and died. And so I had to redo a couple of spots where there was some jumping, where you're trying to jump over, like, gorges and stuff. And I did notice I had a couple issues with that, but once you learn how to, you know, play the game, it's pretty fun. So I definitely would recommend you guys check out X-Men Origins Wolverine for the PlayStation 2. This version is awesome. Like I said, it's a little different than the Xbox 360 and PS3 Uncaged Edition. It, you know, controls similar. You know, you can tack and hack and slash guys around, and really cool. It's also voiced by Hugh Jackman. You know, he voices Wolverine, which is awesome. And he's actually, you know, the perfect part for Wolverine. I definitely couldn't see any actor playing Wolverine. Now, after having Hugh Jackman for 20 years as a Wolverine, you know, he just plays the perfect part for Wolverine, that I just enjoyed it. So definitely check out X-Men Origins Wolverine for PS2 if you have not. Fairly cheap title. I got mine for $5. You could probably get it for around $5 to $10 online. Great game to check out for PS2. And the other game I've been playing, and I've been playing this for the last couple of weeks, been working on beating this series, and that is Mafia 3, which this game is awesome. You know, I was really liking Mafia 1, and I really love the story in Mafia 2, but I'm starting to like Mafia 3 the most as far as my favorite in the series, only because there's just so much more to do in this game. So unlike the first two Mafia games, which are very linear, just story-based only, this is actually an open-world game, so this controls a lot like Grand Theft Auto, plays like Grand Theft Auto. You know, you have missions you can do on your own, you have the main missions, but then you have side missions to do. And it's something I really, really like about this game. So I'm going to read the back for you to get you guys the basic story, because you guys, I don't like to ruin the story, but give you guys the basic premise of it if you haven't ever played it. So it's like, so the rules of organized crime have changed. After years of combat in Vietnam, Lincoln Clay knows this truth. Family isn't who you're born with. It's who you die for. When his surrogate family, the Black Mob, is betrayed and wiped out by the Italian Mafia, Lincoln builds a new family on the ashes of the old and blazes a path of revenge through the brutal criminal underworld responsible. So what's really cool is you actually get to build up your own mafia family. You get to get your own underbosses recruited and your own lieutenants and stuff, your own capos, and you're going after this rival Italian mob. And in order to do that, you know, you have to take care of all his little lieutenants, all his underbosses, his capos, before you finally get to him. And you have to take over the city, which is broke up into several different districts. There's several different rackets, like prostitution, and there's drugs, and there's moonshine. All kinds of really cool different things that you have to take over, which then can earn you money. Because in order for you to take down this rival mafia, you know, you need money to be able to buy weapons, to buy, get soldiers, to get ammo and all that kind of stuff. You know, it takes money. And so you have to take these rackets from him in order to destroy his empire and take over as the new mafia and the new leader of the city. And it's great. I do know that there are a couple different endings to this game. So that's definitely something I'm looking forward to. Another cool thing I want to let you guys know, if you do own a copy of this for Xbox One or PS4, even on Steam, you automatically get a free upgrade to the Definitive Edition, which gives you access to all the DLC. You have three new DLC story modes to go through, plus new weapons and car packs, which is awesome. I've actually beat two of the three DLC missions right now, which is great. I'm working on playing the third one, and then I'm going to resume going back into playing the main story, which is really fun. I'm having a lot of fun with it. I like all the characters in the game. There's actually a connection between Mafia 2 and Mafia 3, which is awesome. I don't want to ruin that connection for anybody who hasn't played. You know, it's a really cool little Easter egg when you see who's in the game that was in number 2. So that's something to look out for, and that little connection there is awesome. Having a lot of fun. Now, I have had a few issues with the game crashing and having loading issues, so the game still has some bugs in it, which I know upset people a lot when the game first came out, and I know this game gets a lot of hate, but I definitely think you guys should check out Mafia 3. It is awesome. I'm having a lot of fun with it, and I'm so glad that I had the Definitive Edition of it now for free, because I get all that extra missions, I get all the extra side stuff, because it does. Those three DLC campaigns also give you extra side missions that you can do on top of their main missions, which is great. And there's already a lot of content in the game. I really like that there's a bunch of different outfits that you can get for Lincoln Clay to wear. There's like different military ones. You also can unlock different outfits as you play through different missions. And there's some really cool ones. There's one where he looks like Morpheus from The Matrix. There's another one where he has like an old school mafia trench coat and suit on. There's another where he has like a business suit on, and then has like a business casual suit, and then there's just some all kinds of different outfits for him to wear, so you can change it up if you get bored. Like I do like mixing up, changing his different outfits. Really cool. I do love the combat in this game, because Lincoln Clay is a former Marine and a special forces guy from Vietnam, so that he kicks ass. And so he knows how to control weapons, he knows how to do things, and he just is awesome. He's also huge, like he's built, like you'll see him, he's much larger than a lot of the characters in the game. And he does absolutely brutal takedown. That's another thing I love about this game, is there's also, you can do stealth in it, so you can sneak up behind guys and you can take out your big Bowie knife, you can stab it right through their neck and snap them. And I saw him use a chain he wrapped around a guy's neck and he snapped it, and he used a, I had one where I had a shotgun, I grabbed a guy and I whacked him in the head, and then I busted his face open with the shotgun, snapped his neck. I mean, it's just awesome, the brutal, like, violent takedowns that are in this game. It's great, because it's brutal and violent, and I love it. Now, I do want to warn people, there are a lot of racist characters in this game because this is set in 1968 in the South, and then the city of New Bordeaux, which is in Louisiana. So basically, it's like a fictional New Orleans. And so there are a lot of racist characters in the game because you're, because Lincoln Clay is African American. You know, there's a lot of people who use the N-word and say racist stuff to him. And so if you know, if you're someone that's, you know, don't like hearing that kind of stuff, just know that that is in the game. And developers, you know, have mentioned, you know, like, we don't condone that kind of behavior, but if we wanted to tell the story the way stuff was in the South in the 60s, you know, we had to include that racial stuff because that's exactly how it happened. And so they wanted to portray a real life character and what he has to struggle through for being an African American in the South in the 60s. So you will have to encounter that, just to let you guys know that. This game also has amazing music. You know, there's three different radio stations, tons of classic 60s music in the game. It's great. Sometimes I just like driving around the city and listening to the music because it's just that good and it's great. Definitely think you guys should give a Mafia 3 a try, especially if you played the first two. I would recommend play through Mafia 1, the definitive edition, beat that one, then play Mafia 2, and then play Mafia 3. It's a wonderful trilogy going over, you know, a span from all the way from the 30s through the 60s. In the world of mob and the organized crime, and it's just a wonderful, wonderful story. I have a lot of fun, like I said, because it's open world like Grand Theft Auto. You can upgrade your vehicles, you can get different weapons, you can buy ammo and stuff, you can get armor to wear for your characters, you have better health, you can upgrade Lincoln Clay so you can get more health, you can carry more health packs and stuff like that. Like, it's just a great game. I'm having a lot of fun since it's open world. Like, this is exactly the perfect way for Mafia to go from being a linear story to a more open world story like Grand Theft Auto game. And that definitely was a great progression that they did with the story. So definitely check out Mafia 3. So as always, guys, you know, we always go over our little recap of the games I talked about. I've been talked about X-Men Origins Wolverine for PlayStation 2. This is a fantastic game, especially if you're a big fan of Wolverine like I am. Now, if you've already played the Uncaged Edition for Xbox 360 or PS3, you definitely owe it to yourself to play this one because it's a little bit different, plays similar, not as good graphics as it's on the PS2, but still handles pretty well. There's a couple little issues I noticed where, like, the button's not responding, but overall, it does control well, and it has a fun story that's more closely related to the movie than the ones on the 360 and PS3 versions were, so definitely give that a try. And then we also talked about Mafia 3, wonderful game in the Mafia series. I'm having a blast with it. I'm about probably halfway done with the main story now, and I've gone through two of the three DLCs, and I'm working on beating the third one, and I'm hoping to have this one beat by the end of the year. I just can't put this down. Like, I'm playing it every night for a few hours just because I love the game that much. There are collectibles again in the game. You know, you have the Playboy magazines to find with your nude women, which, hey, you know, I like women. Nude women's great. There's also some Vargas paintings, which are more paintings of naked women. There's album covers, so there's really cool different covers of the different bands that were really around that time you can check out. There's also communist propaganda things to take down. And then there's these Hot Rod magazines that were just like in the previous Mafias, to find those magazines. And then there's some religious Repent magazines or something. I don't know. I haven't found those yet. But there's a lot of collectibles in the game to find. And I did forget to mention, though, that there are there's these little note things that you get because there's a guy from the CIA that works with you. You can actually unlock these little node areas, and it'll actually display all the collectibles on the map for you, which makes it easier to actually find them, which is something I really like. You know, they didn't have that in the first two games. It's something they added for the third game that makes it a lot easier to get all the collectibles. So definitely check that out. So let me know your guys' thoughts if you played X-Men Origins Wolverine for PS2, or if you guys have played Mafia 3 yet, and let me know what your guys' thoughts are. Of course, I want to hear what games you guys have been playing. And if you guys have any recommendations on a title you think I should check out, let me know, because you guys always recommend really good titles. I want to thank you guys for watching. Take care. You guys have a great day, and Sleepy will see you next time.